30 years ago, a remote town in Ukraine saw a catastrophic nuclear disaster. Now, a research team has documented that the site is home to a thriving wildlife population. In April of 1986, an explosion at the Chernobyl nuclear power plant resulted in the worst nuclear accident in history. The resulting fire lasted 10 days and released an untold amount of radioactive materials into the atmosphere to gradually fall out over the surrounding countryside. An area stretching about 1,000 square miles around the disaster site is still designated the Chernobyl exclusion zone, unfit for human habitation. But research over the years has shown that in our absence, wildlife is thriving. A study from 2015 found substantial animal tracks. And as of April 2016, a University of Georgia team has documented 14 species of mammals using remote station cameras, mostly wolves and raccoon dogs, aka tanuki. The cameras were set up for a week each at 94 sites and baited with a fatty acid scent to attract animals, particularly carnivores. The team was focused on the top of the food chain because these critters receive the most radiation exposure, directly from the air, soil, and water, as all animals would, but also from the contamination accumulated in their prey. The international science community is still trying to figure out how much damage all the radiation from Chernobyl has caused, and is still causing. And okay, radiation is all around us, all of us. Light, heat, radio waves, and microwaves are non-ionizing radiation. They carry enough energy to excite atoms, but not to break them apart. But X-rays, gamma rays, and emissions from radioactive materials are ionizing radiation. They can bust electrons right out of their atoms. On a cellular level, that's what scientists refer to as bad. Ionizing radiation can break apart the genes that tell your cells and systems how to function, causing all kinds of health problems. But there's no consensus on how much damage different levels of exposure can cause in the long run. There just isn't enough data for us to draw from. All we can do is watch the populations affected, human and wildlife alike, and wait. The team from UGA says that higher levels of contamination didn't suppress wildlife populations. Rather, the animals they observed went wherever food and water could be found regardless. They're hoping that further studies will measure the animals' health and survival rates. So what do you think about all this? Would you tour Chernobyl? Get in touch and let us know. And for lots more about what's going on in science right now, head to our home planet, now.howstuffworks.com.